Welcome everybody to another video of Ancient Greece Reloaded. Today we will talk about the famous gods Uraea. By the way, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so as to stay tuned for upcoming videos. Alright, when Gaia, the Earth Mother, came into being, some of the first of her many, many children were quite literally a part of her. Out of her body and attached to it were the Uraea, the firstborn elemental god spirits of stone and rock, the spirits of the steep, craggy mountains that crisscross the Greek world. The Uraea numbered 10 and showed up on the scene shortly after Gaia's husband Uranos, aka the heavens, did. Unlike most Greek mythological figures, the spirits of the stone didn't have a father at all. She just willed them into being, and before long they stood majestically rising out from her earthen body. Each and every mountain was said to have its own ancient, serious and wise bearded spirit that gave it life, and they were often shown as wrinkly yet still powerful looking old men and women rising up from between the craggy peaks. The Uraea also had cousins called the Nessii, the god spirits of islands, which were busted and broken off from the mountains and cast into the sea by Poseidon, forming the many islands that surrounded Greece itself. By the way guys, our next video will be about the Nessii. Hence, you can subscribe to our channel so as to stay tuned for upcoming videos. That being said, the 10 Uraea were Etna, Athos, Helicon, Kithaeron, Nisos, Olympus 1, yep there were 2, Olympus 2, Oreos, Parnes and Tmolus. Sadly, there aren't any real exciting stories about any of them. After all, how much can a mountain do? It's not as if they can really go anywhere, as they kept fairly quiet and lived life in the slow lake, thinking slow, deep thoughts and watching the world go by beneath them. Even though they didn't gain much attention at adventure in the stories, each mountain was said to have its own local tenders, called Ureads, and they do have some info to give up. An Ureat was a type of nymph that lived up in the mountains, down in the valleys and in deep, dark ravines, tending to and watching over the land around their given Urea. There are many families of Ureads who differed from each other depending on what mountain they called home. For instance, the Idaea were from Mount Ida, the Peleads from Mount Pelion, etc. The Ureads were good girl poles of Artemis, the goddess of the hunt, since Artemis preferred the high, rare air of the mountains, the rocky cliffs and precipices of the wooden slopes when she headed out for hunting. That made the Ureads the perfect companions for her when she stayed there for a while to get her hunt on. While not much is ever said about the Urea, there is one exception. A few details are tossed out there about a rather stony-faced guy who wore around a cloak made entirely of oak trees, an Urea named Tmolus. Tmolus wasn't just the spirit of Mount Tmolus, he was also the king of an area called Lydia and husband to a beautiful girl named Omphale. In one situation, he acted as the judge of a musical contest between the two musically talented gods Pan and Apollo, which Apollo narrowly won. Sadly, Tmolus was gored to death by a raging bull on the mountain that bears his name. His poor widow, Omphale, did him proud and became queen ruler of Lydia herself. And at this point, we have reached the end of our video. Let us know in the comment section below if we have forgotten something to talk about in the video, so that other viewers can read and learn from your comments. If you liked the video, remember to hit the like button and to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for upcoming videos.